Okay, I am starting natural language processing in this session today. What is natural language processing? This is the third domain of AI. As we know, AI has three domains: computer vision, data sciences, and natural language processing. So the third domain is natural language processing. The third domain of AI is natural language processing, and in short, we call it NLP. NLP takes in the data of natural languages which humans use in their daily lives and operates on this. What does it mean? As we know that computer understands only computer language, or we can say machines understand only machine languages. But now with NLP, means natural language processing, the third domain of AI, it is possible to make machine understand human languages. So this is the power of AI. Now NLP helps machines to understand human languages and operates on this. So natural language processing or NLP is the subfield of AI. It is not any other area. It is the subfield of AI, and it focused on enabling computers to understand and process human languages. This is very important because this is the whole processing area of NLP, means because it can understand human, it makes the computer understand human languages. So there are many possibilities now with human languages interaction and operations with NLP. Now what is the definition of NLP? Natural language processing or NLP is the subfield of AI, we came to know this, that is focused on enabling computers to understand and process human languages. क्या दो बातें हमें पता चली? First, NLP is the subfield of AI. And second, it focused on enabling computers to understand and process human languages. So first, we have to take these two points in the definition of NLP. Then we can add one more point, that NLP is a subfield of these areas. What? Subfield of linguistics, computer sciences, information engineering, and artificial intelligence. If you want to elaborate your answer, you can add one more thing, that concerned with the interaction between computers and human languages, means the areas which I mentioned here, which are known as the for which the NLP is subfield, these areas concerned with the interaction between computers and human languages. So that part relate these areas with NLP. NLP is a subfield of linguistics, computer science, information engineering, and artificial engineering, concerned with the interaction between computers and human languages. In particular, how to program computers to process and analyze large amount of natural language data. इसका पूरा मतलब क्या हो रहा है कि NLP AI की सबफील्ड है जो फोकस करती है कंप्यूटर को इनेबल करने में, जिससे वो ह्यूमन लैंग्वेज को समझ सके, अंडरस्टैंड कर पाए और प्रोसेस कर पाए. एंड सेकेंड थिंग, NLP इज ऑल्सो द सबफील्ड ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक, कंप्यूटर साइंस, इंफॉर्मेशन इंजीनियरिंग. AI तो है ही है. सो दीज आर दी फील्ड्स फॉर विच NLP इज अ सबफील्ड. ओके, नाउ ये एरियाज जो हमने अभी बोले हैं, लिंग्विस्टिक्स, कंप्यूटर साइंस, इंफॉर्मेशन इंजीनियरिंग एंड आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, कंसर्न विद द इंटरेक्शन बिटवीन कंप्यूटर एंड ह्यूमन लैंग्वेजेस. ठीक है, इनमें हम उन एरियाज को ले रहे हैं जिसमें इंटरेक्शन होता है कंप्यूटर और ह्यूमन लैंग्वेज का. इन पर्टिकुलर, हाउ टू प्रोग्राम कंप्यूटर्स टू प्रोसेस एंड एनालाइज लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ नेचुरल लैंग्वेज डेटा. जब नेचुरल लैंग्वेज डेटा बहुत ज्यादा होता है, लार्ज अमाउंट में होता है, और उसकी प्रोसेसिंग या उसकी एनालिसिस के लिए हम कंप्यूटर प्रोग्राम्स यूज कर रहे हैं, तब हम NLP यूज करेंगे. सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ NLP ओवरऑल? Natural language processing or NLP is the subfield of AI that is focused on enabling computers to understand and process human languages. And if you are having the question for more than one mark or more than two, you can add more points. NLP is a subfield of linguistics, computer science, information engineering, and artificial intelligence, concerned with the interaction between computers and human languages. In particular, how to program computer to process and analyze large amount of natural language data. So you can learn the definition in three parts, but this one line definition is also good enough. How NLP make it possible? How do computer do that? How do they understand what we say in our language? So you can experience this program, this game, AI game, Mystery Animal. So you can do this at your spare time. In this game, you have to guess the name of the animal by answering the 20 yes or no question. So aap is pe link bhi diya hua hai maine. By clicking on this link, you can open the Google Chrome tab where you can play the game Mystery Animal. This is a voice experiment actually. Totally it takes all the input in voice. You have to speak the question and then the computer will give you the answer in audio form, and this way you have to identify the animal within 20 yes or no question. Now applications of NLP. Since artificial intelligence nowadays is becoming an integral part of our lives, its applications are very commonly used by the majority of people in their daily lives. Let us discuss some of the applications of NLP which are used in our real life scenario. First is automatic summarization. Four basic applications yahan pe hum mention kar rahe hain, and whenever you will get any question regarding applications of NLP in class 10th, you have to write these applications. In short, I am first showing the name of these application. First is automatic summarization. Then next one is automatic summarization ke baad next sentiment analysis, and then next is text classification, and then virtual assistant. So these are the four applications which you can mention while answering on the question applications of NLP. Okay. So first is automatic summarization. Information overload is a real problem. We have lot of information, and as we know that information technology ke age mein information bahut importance rakhta hai. But now this overloaded information need to be concise. So this is a big problem that we have an overloaded information. Now when we need to access a specific important piece of information from a huge knowledge base, it is a big problem to find out. So automatic summarization is relevant not only for summarizing the meaning of documents and information, but also to understand the emotional meaning within the information. So this area of NLP, automatic summarization, not only summarizing the meaning of the document or information, but also finding the emotions within the information. Means suppose agar aapne koi blog hai ya koi news hai jisko is tool ke through summarize kiya, aur us headline ek tarah se aapne jo find out ki, usse wo emotion bhi find out kar sakta hai. Such as in collecting data from social media. जैसे social media में जब आप कोई post देखते हो, तो through emojis or through few words, automatic summarization tool can find the emotion of that blog or that post also. Automatic summarization is especially relevant when used to provide an overview of a news item or blog post. Same I have told you right now that if you want to summarize any news item or blog post, then you can use automatic summarization. Suppose आपको daily एक project मिला कि daily morning आपको अपने class के सामने current news देनी है daily, तो आप इतनी जल्दी सारे news नहीं पढ़ सकते, सारे news को summarize नहीं कर सकते, then you can use the automatic summarization tool to find the current news, headlines of today's news. So this way you can find the information quickly, concrete information, and this way you can avoid redundancy from multiple sources and maximizing the diversity of the content obtained. आपको वही बार-बार news हर post पे मिल रही है, websites पे, news websites पे मिल रही है, तो आप वो redundancy reduce करोगे, avoid करोगे, and you can maximize the diversity. आपके पास ज़्यादा diverse information होगी, okay? So this is online tool available for automatic summarization. I have posted a snapshot there just to get a look of that. See, there is a text, piece of text written at the left hand side of this box, and right hand side it is summarizing. This way the computer we can make the computer enable to summarize the information. Summarizing the meaning of document and information. See the source text. What is written here? Peter and Elizabeth took a taxi to attend the night party in the city. While in the party, Elizabeth collapsed and was rushed to the hospital. Now, what is the summary made by this tool? Peter and Elizabeth attend party, city, Elizabeth rushed hospital. So don't think that these tools will give you grammatically correct answer. It is not necessary. The main purpose of these tools are to give the essence of information. Okay. This is another example of automatic summarization tool. See emotions, how it find the emotion. See the text is written, can't ask for a better service. So with this text, okay, now the text is changed. Wait a minute, I will tell you again. Okay, now see. Okay, hotel, nothing out of the ordinary. So with this text, what you can say? It is neutral because nothing ordinary, the words it takes and make the sense. Can't ask for better service. It's positive because better, there is a word better. And can't is not big deal here, so it is give the positive result. If I found a rat in my room, disgusting. So this disgusting word give it a negative value. So it is negative. Emotion is negative. So this way, automatic summarization tool can also find out the emotion of the text. Now this is another example. See how it is finding the summary of the text. You can get many of the tool available online. And you can explore and experience the working of this tool. This example is showing how automatic summarization tool is providing the overview of a news item or a blog post. Now, sentiment analysis. This is second application of natural language processing. The goal of sentiment analysis is quite related to emotion analysis. The goal of sentiment analysis is to identify sentiment among several posts or even in the same post where emotion is not always explicitly expressed. Ab sentiment analysis means kya hai? Almost emotion lag rahe. Goal, the goal of the sentiment analysis is to identify sentiment among several posts. बहुत सारे पोस्ट को देख के या सेम पोस्ट को एनालाइज करके वो फाइंड आउट करता है. एंड कंपनीज यूज नेचुरल लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग एप्लीकेशन सच एज सेंटीमेंट एनालिसिस टू आइडेंटिफाई ओपिनियन एंड सेंटीमेंट ऑनलाइन टू हेल्प देम अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट कस्टमर्स थिंक अबाउट देयर प्रोडक्ट्स एंड सर्विसेज. यू कैन सी व्हेनेवर यू आर डाउनलोडिंग एनी एप्लीकेशन फ्रॉम प्ले स्टोर और ऑनलाइन, देन यू कैन सी देयर आर रिव्यूज. उन रिव्यूज के थ्रू क्या हो रहा है, क्या पर्पज है कंपनीज का टू गेट द रिव्यूज ऑफ द कस्टमर्स. द पर्पज इज टू गेट द कमेंट्स, इमोशन, सेंटिमेंट, एक्सपीरियंस एंड एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ देयर प्रोडक्ट फ्रॉम द कस्टमर्स. उसके थ्रू क्या मिलेगा कंपनीज को, दे कैन गेट द नेगेटिव पॉइंट्स एंड पॉजिटिव पॉइंट ऑफ देयर प्रोडक्ट एंड दे कैन एनालाइज एंड दे कैन इम्प्रूव देयर प्रोडक्ट फॉर बेटर सर्विसेज. So the company can be benefited. So this way we can use these tools, sentiment analysis, to get the sentiment of customers. Like I love the new iPhone. Customer has written the review, I love the new iPhone, and a few lines later, but sometimes it doesn't work well, where the person is still talking about the iPhone and overall indicators of their reputation. तो हमें पता चल रहा है ना इससे कि इस हेयर द सेंटिमेंट इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग विद दिस टेक्स्ट. सो टूल्स कैन बी फाइंड आउट दिस सेंटिमेंट्स विद द टेक्स्ट. सी द एग्जांपल. दिस इज द वन इंटरनेट ब्रांड रिव्यूज. The customer Andrew Young written 30% packet loss. Fix your slow internet, please. Here, slow. This word slow reflecting the negative sentiment. So, the same way, another customer is writing half an hour to load 5 minutes video. Nice. And three emojis of angry sentiment. So this way it is giving the negative sentiment. Third, I have been a loyal customer of One Internet for years and I am utterly satisfied with the service. So here you can see the word satisfied is giving the sentiment of the customer and it shows that it is a positive sentiment. This way companies taking reviews and with reviews they are analyzing the sentiment and with these sentiments they can rate their product and can improve their services. Companies using NLP to identify opinions and sentiment online to help them understand what customers think about their products and services and overall indicators of their reputation. This is another example you can see here in phone. Beyond determining simple polarity, sentiment analysis understands sentiment in context to help better understand what's behind an expressed opinion, which can be extremely relevant in understanding and driving purchasing decisions. Beyond determining simple polarity, agar aap usse thoda aage ja rahe ho, to sentiment analysis ke through sentiment in context to help better understand what's behind an expressed opinion. Jo opinion express ki gayi hai, uske piche kya reason hai, which can be extremely relevant in understanding and driving purchasing decision. Aap customers ke jab reviews dekh rahe hain, to aap akko agar decision lena hai ki which product is, aap jaate ho na Amazon.com pe, to wahan pe aapko reviews ke through aap jo bhi opinion hai customers ke previously diye gaye hain, uske piche aap agar unka रीजन देखते हो क्यों दिया है क्या प्रोडक्ट था तो आपके लिए डिसीजन लेना आसान होता है. ओके दिस वन इज नॉट गुड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रीजन. तो आपका क्या पर्पस है उस प्रोडक्ट को लेने का आप ये भी फाइंड कर सकते हैं. तो सेंटिमेंट एनालिसिस नॉट ओनली बेनिफिटिंग कंपनीज बट ऑल्सो बेनिफिटिंग कस्टमर्स. टेक्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन द इमेज शोइंग यू द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ classification, text classification. This is done by classification engine and online tool. Here is an example of inbox. When you are getting a number of mails, then there is a classification engine working in your inbox, which is categorizing the mails in different categories. You can see in your inbox, spams are there, then social mails are there, and kuch marketing ya मतलब आपके ना अलग से कुछ डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज आपने भी बना रखे हैं अगर फैमिलीज या फैमिली फ्रेंड्स तो उसको कैटेगराइज कर सकता है. एंड टेक्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन मेक्स इट पॉसिबल टू असाइन प्री डिफाइंड कैटेगरीज व्हाट एवर डिफाइंड बाय द कंपनी और द यूजर टू डॉक्यूमेंट एंड ऑर्गेनाइज इट टू हेल्प यू फाइंड द इंफॉर्मेशन यू नीड और सिंप्लीफाई सम एक्टिविटीज. The example is a spam filter. So with the help of this text classification tool of NLP, spam filter work to find the spams. So this is an example of text categorization. Now virtual assistants. Nowadays Google Assistant, Cortana, Siri, Alexa, etc. have become an integral part of our lives. Not only can we talk to them, but they also have the abilities to make our lives easier. By accessing our data, they can help us in keeping notes of our tasks, make calls for us, send messages, and a lot more. With the help of speech recognition, these assistants can not only detect our speech, but can also make sense out of it. According to recent researchers, a lot more advancements are expected in this field in the near future. Means, aap jante ho ki these virtual assistants can help you to listen or speech and answer in audio, but also आप उनको notes कुछ अगर आपको task के लिए notes देने हैं वो उसको save करेंगे. call करने हैं तो आप simply Google Assistant को अगर कहते हो call this, make a call to any person, any contact, it can come make call. If you want to send any message or any mail, you can give the audio message, audio command. So this way speech recognition help to do these type of tasks. So it not only detect our speech, but now it also makes sense out of it. Means suppose you are going somewhere out and you are making any appointment somewhere, then it can give you the information about weather, etc., to make you aware about the environment, outside weather also. See the example, hey Google, play it. So this way, these are the orders. Hey Google, reserve. Hey Google, schedule. Hey Google, play. Hey Google, mail. So these type of commands work with virtual assistant, Google assistant. And the another example I am showing right hand side, how Google work with textual message. You can write the text and it will work. Switch off watchdog timers. It will work. These are the examples, snapshot of examples only. Now these are the four virtual assistants which are most popular one nowadays. So you can identify their name. What is the first virtual assistant? Yes, it's Google Assistant. The second one, Cortana. The third one, Siri. And the fourth one, Alexa. This is the example of another piece of work of virtual assistant. According to recent research, a lot more advancement are expected in this field in the near future. As I told you that, like, see here, what is happening here? Are you still hiking today? I heard it might rain today. Let's see, what is the weather like today? Don't forget to take umbrella. Aapne usko sirf itni information, itni question pucha tha ki weather kaisa hai. And Google help you to give the answer, giving you the answer and also giving you a suggestion. Don't forget sunglasses agar weather aapka sunny hai. और अगर आपका रेनी है तो giving you the suggestion, take umbrella or raincoat. So this way it is beyond only the informative helper. आपको सिर्फ एक information नहीं दे रहा है, एक help नहीं कर रहा है, वो आपको इससे ज़्यादा भी कुछ कर रहा है, जो एक अभी recent research के through ये development हो रहे हैं. तो कुछ और advancement virtual assistant में near future में हमें देखने को मिलेंगे. Okay, now the next part, natural language processing, getting started. Now I will tell you how to work with natural language processing. Means we will understand the procedure of the whole process of this text normalization and summarization, etc. So first I'm ending my this PPT here and I want to start another one in the another video. So this part I will take in another video. Bye bye.